And now, the officials are ready. The fighters are ready. For the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the blue corner, with trainer, former world champion Buddy McGirt, wearing shamrock green and officially weighing 158 pounds. As a professional, his fighting record stands at 28 victories, including 19 knockouts, with only 3 defeats. From Birmingham, and representing all the Irish the world over, the former Irish, British, and two-time European middleweight champion, the number 2 ranked middleweight contender in the world, Matthew Macklin. And fighting out of the red corner with his trainer, Pablo Sarmiento, wearing red with black, official weight, 157.5 pounds. His professional record in the ring, 48 victories with 27 knockouts to his credit, only 2 defeats and 2 draws. And he is rated among the top fighters pound for pound in the world today. From Quilmes, Argentina, the reigning, defending, universally recognized true middleweight champion of the world, Sergio Maravilla Martinez.
Just about ready to go. Also joining us ringside is Amir Khan. Amir, a quick comment from you. Can Macklin do this?
Yes, I can. Yeah, I think he can do it. You know, he's looking in great shape. He feels confident. If you look at him there, he looks in great shape, and I think he can pull it off. I mean, Martinez looks in good shape as well, but I think we're going to see how quick Macklin starts. I think he's on a quick start, and
all right,
I think
boxers,
he can do it.
You've already received your instructions. I commend you to obey my commands and protect yourself at all times. All right, let's touch glove. I expect a good, clean fight. Let's go.
Good luck.
Eddie Cotton, the referee who handled Lewis against Tyson, and Darren Barker's unsuccessful attempt to dethrone Sergio Martinez in his most recent defense. There's been one or two silly shenanigans involving the WBC. Don't argue about that. Martinez, by everyone's estimation, is the top middleweight in the world, and Macklin will take on that mantle should he beat him here. But it's a big, big ask, and he's quite a lengthy outsider. He's in the green trunks here, Macklin. Macklin representing his native Birmingham and, of course, Ireland, where his parents come from. Needs a high work rate, but it's a fast start from Martinez. He's a southpaw and a quick one too, even at the age of 37.
See, I think Macklin has come in with a plan to try something different from the Sturm fight. I don't know if he's capable of outboxing this man, but thinking fighters like to work at their own pace, they like to control the pace. It's important that Macklin does not allow that, but Martinez has settled very quickly, landed a couple of decent shots already.
Looks like he's determined to straight away to say who's boss and not let Macklin do what he did against Felix Sturm and win all the early rounds, throwing, well, hundreds of punches. I think it was 1,100 in the end, wasn't it? He's going to find this guy harder to get to, isn't he?
See, Macklin will find it difficult to find rhythm against Sturm. Sturm stood there blocking punches, so you can let them flow, but against a moving target who's a quick puncher himself, he can't do the same. He's going to have to find success. He's going to have to work for every punch that he lands, which he didn't have to do against Sturm. And you can see already how it looks up and how sharp Martinez is. Sharp right jab from him there again.
Some good work though by Macklin, who studied Martinez's every move, every inch of tape there is of him, and kind of knows exactly everything he tries. Whether he can do something about that is key here. Whether he's good enough, basically.
Well, he's spending the first round trying to find ways to get into punching range to get some punches off. Hasn't really managed that. He's working onto that jab there. Got some himself though. The southpaw jab, he's had good southpaw sparring, but all southpaws are different. And this fellow really is a work of art at times from that southpaw stance. Left hand lead.
One of Macklin's most traumatic defeats was against the southpaw, a real thriller against Jamie Moore. But he's in a different era of his career now, I think it's fair to say.
And I don't think he's fought a southpaw since, Ian.
Finding it hard to catch an elusive Martinez early on, Macklin.
Yeah, this is the problem. It's difficult to find rhythm against a moving target. When the first punch misses, then you're off balance and you're not set for the second one. No, I think Martinez is setting a little bit quicker.
Come on, step back.
Just a hint of redness around the left eye of Macklin from the early exchanges.
The delicious new Aero, now with more bubbles than ever. Join us on Facebook to make the world a bubblier place.
There's the Sergio Martinez corner. That's Pablo Sarmiento, who some British fans might remember fighting Colin Lines and Billy Schwer, British lightweights at the time.
See, that's the southpaw jab that's going to cause so many problems for Macklin. He did get close a few times, but left hand leads the southpaw, so I think Macklin is just going to have to go back to what he does best. That's all out aggression.
Martinez will be anxious not to let Macklin make it his kind of fight. What he wants is fast-paced aggression, throwing lots of punches, applying pressure. Hasn't been able to really do that so far. Macklin saying in the build-up, I'm going to make him feel every single day of his 37 years. But at the moment, Martinez, I mean, what he could do is, maybe with a better skill set, just dominate the fight with his pace and experience and soften him up and look to take him out later on. I mean, that's the worst case scenario for Matthew Macklin, isn't it?
I mean, we have to give Matthew credit. He is a genuine world-class performer, but he's just struggling to get close enough to do anything effective. The right hand, sorry, left hand lead from that southpaw stance. Just so many unexpected things that Martinez does. He's not conventional. You get a southpaw, so you can solve them out, no problem. But this guy, 15 years, he's been in every situation. He's so adaptable, so difficult to beat. And you can see this early, that he is really primed up for a tough challenge tonight.
He's got to be a bit cute as well, Macklin, because everybody remembers the chilling left hand with which Martinez took out Paul Williams in their rematch in the second round. So he has got to dig there if he catches you right.
Macklin just missing, just can't pin him down. He's going to have to be patient. It's no good becoming frustrated. I'm sure they expected this to be difficult in the early stages. Oh, beautiful shot. Oh, he wasn't hurt by the punch. He caught him square-footed. He wasn't hurt by it, but thankfully he didn't go over, because that would have been a disaster, because it would have been a knockdown.
There's a smile from Macklin and a little shake of the head towards Martinez to say, I know that look, but you didn't really hurt me.
Bean, we hardly saw that punch coming. No. Matthew certainly did. Beautiful shot that was.
That's what he does. He can find punches from angles his opponents do not expect. He's looking for the body, I think, Macklin. I think he's hoping he can slow Martinez down later on in the fight, and maybe it'll take time, but that's the theory.
Well, I know the plan, Ernestine, was going to aim punches to the chest. But the trouble is, he's not even getting close enough, really. That little half step back, lovely stuff again from Martinez. The feet get tied up a little bit, as happens quite a lot with southpaw and orthodox. But he's slick, he's quick. And Macklin just struggling to get close. Grabbing hold there up close, Martinez.
And then quite happy to mix it on the inside with Macklin, who's not really being able to fight his fight here so far. So one or two problems to solve.
Yeah, I think it's the speed of the punching of Martinez and the speed on his feet. He's just never still.
You feel like he's going too far away, you got to get a little bounce and close the gap. You can't walk flat-footed. You got to let him bounce and close the gap with the head movement, okay?
Yeah.
But just be careful now. Like I said, don't get caught with those left hands. He's trying to lure you in. Okay, when he starts moving away, you go out and over. Cut him off. Take him out of his rhythm. Don't follow him. That's what he wants you to do. Keep throwing that straight right hand to the body, baby.
Amir Khan with us at ringside. It's not started well for Matthew, really.
Okay. It's not, you know, it's like a game of chess, and Martinez is waiting for him to come in so he can catch him with that big backhand he's throwing. And he caught him then in that last round with a nice backhand, and, you know, Matthew just went off balance. But I think Matthew just needs to put a little bit more pressure on him, rough him up a little bit in the inside, and just push him around and push him back.
Thanks, Amir. We'll get his comments from time to time as this goes on. One of the problems Macklin has is having to reach a little. He's getting with the body shot there. That was more the kind of thing he's looking for.
Macklin's going to have to accept the fact that he's going to miss with punches. He's going to have to throw threes and fours. Be prepared to miss for the first couple. Try to box your way close to this fellow and catch him with leading jabs. I think he's going to try that all night long without success. Raise the tempo, but let punches go and threes and fours. Bring the right hand into play a bit more.
See if he can do that. Better start to the round for Macklin in the first few seconds anyway. And this time it's Martinez who is having to reach. He is very, very unorthodox. He's tricky and clever and classy with it as well, which is why everybody thinks he's right up there in the current pound-for-pound argument. This is better for Macklin in this round so far.
Missing with the punches, though, Ian. He's not finding the target. That was a little bit closer. The movement is good from Martinez, but he's not coming back with too much of his own, so moving away is not enough.
This Argentinian's good at setting traps for his opponents as well. Pretty good for a guy who never laced on the gloves till he was 20 years of age.
Yeah, just a natural athlete, that's what he is. Well, this is good. Macklin roughing him up a lot, but up close. Martinez hasn't really produced all that much so far in this round. KG making Matthew miss, but not coming back too often.
Macklin himself is a good student of the business. He watches lots and lots of tapes, thinks about it. Spend a lot of time in that New York apartment envisaging how it might be tonight. Well, this is how it's going to be. Stakes could not be higher.
Martinez is guilty of holding up close, Ian.
Kane looking for that body shot, having to reach with it. And when he reaches, there's the danger of leaving himself open to one of those quick, rapier-like left-hand counters.
I think this is a round you can see whatever way you like, because there's not a lot of good clean punches been landed. A lot more work from Macklin, that's better. He's bringing that right hand into play, which is very important here.
I'll tell you the way I'm seeing it, it's Macklin's round. I don't think Martinez has done much in this round at all. This is better from Macklin. And he's on the cards, I think, here, or he should be with this round.
I want to stand and salute that.
The boys watch the girls while the girls watch the boys who watch the girls go by.
Pretty face comes along and everything goes out the window.
Eye to eye, they solemnly convene to make the scene.
I'm so glad I got to roam those hillsides.
Mad Men starts Tuesday, March 27th on Sky Atlantic HD.
Here's Martinez, who's beaten Kelly Pavlik, Paul Williams, Sergei Zinjiruk, and Darren Barker of Great Britain in his world title fights. It's taken him about 13 years to be an overnight sensation. Macklin, kind of the same, really. A bit shorter in his perspective. For a long time, I thought Macklin was just going to be a wasted talent. It was a bit too fond of his social life, but he's really buckled down in the last few years to become something.
Yeah, I think it's when they realised time was running short that he gave it his full attention.
Super dedicated now. In the green trunks, the Birmingham-based Matthew Macklin. And that's a good little right hand to end the rally. And again, there's a little half smile from Macklin towards Martinez.
See, again, you can see when he puts punches together, the first couple may miss, but the second and third maybe get home, and that's what impresses the judges. Martinez at times has an ugly style. And Macklin drawing him into the right kind of battle now, I feel.
Yeah. Better in the last 3 or 4 minutes from Macklin, who does have a good boxing brain, I think, or has developed one anyway. Sometimes in a fighter's life, everything is crystallized into one night. And fighters, a lot of smiling through the gum shield. And little arches of the eyebrows back from Martinez in there too, isn't it?
Macklin made him miss with a few shots and then smiled as if to say, you're not the only one causing problems.
They both look as if they're kind of enjoying the chess match element of it. Oh, left hand, it buckled the knees.
I think their feet were tied up there, Ian. I think he tripped over the southpaw leading leg. I think, again, it looked as though he was hurt, but I don't believe he was. But that's the type of things that can impress judges.
Yeah, see? I think he seems all right. I think you're probably right, Jim. The old knees just buckled for a moment. They could have been the trip, couldn't it?
Yeah, I think the leading legs just get a little bit tied up.
Yeah.
But Martinez getting the jab off a little bit quicker again, complaining about a low blow. Quite right, Matthew. Protect yourself at all times.
Yeah. And he'll regard that as a good sign, I think, Macklin, that Martinez is just giving out a little moan like that in mid-fight instead of getting on with it.
Martinez again dropping his hands down to his knees as he's done in a lot of previous fights. Dangerous, especially against such an aggressive fighter as Macklin. Macklin not making the same impression in this round, I don't feel.
No.
Is that southpaw jab?
That's probably his hardest shot so far. Landed pretty flush the right hand from Macklin. But it is a bit like trying to solve a Rubik's Cube, working out Martinez's style.
But bringing the right hand into play has worked for him. He has to, as I say, be prepared to miss for some punches, but put them together. Maybe Martinez just nicked that one.
I believe you're right. It's Buddy McGird, who fought 25 times at Madison Square Garden, the trainer. Somewhere in that corner is Seamus, his brother, is constantly with Matthew. He's a good little fighter himself. That's the scene here in the Madison Square Garden Theatre, which is just about sold out with 5,000 fans. Not bad, because the New York Rangers are at home tonight as well. It's quite a crush. Amir Khan, what do you think so far then?
Yeah, Matthew's boxing a good fight. He's doing what he has to do. I mean, stick to that long jump. And movement's amazing. I mean, Martinez is coming stronger, but you can see how Macklin's breaking him down now, getting them backhands in. And I think more backhands and left hooks, I think that would be better for Macklin, really. But you can see Macklin now getting warmed up and he's coming in stronger now.
Thank you, Amir.
Seen a little bit of facial damage on Macklin there at the end of the round.
Nothing for him to worry about, though, is it? Not at the moment.
Nope.
This is the fifth round. Just be wary of Macklin's targeting the body of Martinez. Just once or twice, the undisputed world number one in this division has just looked a little uncomfortable with that and given out one or two little, not distress signals, but moans to the referee. It gets him with the right hand again, Macklin.
See, I think Martinez is making mistakes, just leading with the single punches. Bringing the left hand into play there a bit more, but yeah, the hands down at the knees.
Interestingly, our colleagues at HBO, the American Fight commentary team, they've got the fight level at this point, Jim.
Well, I mean, I've Martinez nicking a couple of the rounds, but let's face it, there hasn't been a lot in any of the rounds.
Quite a clever performance, this, from Macklin. He's looked to make the tactical adjustments. He knew, I think, that the plan that worked with Felix Sturm to an extent wasn't going to be really applicable with this guy. Completely different style.
Martinez still not really putting punches together. Just flicking with the southpaw jab, nothing all that impressive. Showboating a little bit.
Just look for Macklin throwing those punches in bunches that Jim was saying and trying to land with the third and fourth, even if the first two miss. He's doing that a bit more. This is a better round again for Macklin.
See, that's what you have to do, throw more punches. I think maybe now he's just warming to the task. I think maybe he was worried about making basic mistakes in the early stages. Things are beginning to work, so I think there's a little bit more confidence now in Macklin's work. This is good.
Another good right hand from him. He's had a fair bit of success in this session, has Macklin. And again, quite meaty. Martinez might be starting to think, well, this might be something a little tougher than they said. 10-1 on with some bookmakers, Martinez, to win this.
Martinez wasn't breathing quite heavy at the end of the previous round in the corner, left hook from Macklin. This is good. He's letting punches flow now. This is what he has to do, bring the right hand into play. Lovely.
I know this is Macklin's best round yet, this one, the fifth. He's been the boss in this round again. He gets the better of it. For the last punch came from him. Back came Martinez with a thumping left hand. It's really warming up here. I think he was rattled a little bit. And this is really boiling up. Well, quite a finish to the round there. The plot is thickening, I'd say, Jim.
Macklin seems to have solved some of the problems. It looked to me, I can't get a look at Matthew, the angle or that, but I thought there was some swelling over the right eye. I'd like a look at that. Hopefully there's not no facial damage. But that was a terrific round. He put his punches together.
Okay, just stay relaxed, baby.
Nice breath.
Nice deep breath, baby. Very good. Stay smart. Don't start reaching. You're starting to get a little reach.
Yep, when he brings the right hand into play, single punch is no good. But when he brings that right hand in, it's worked so often. Terrific stuff from Macklin.
All Matthew Macklin's family and friends are here, led by his mother, Kathleen, who we were talking to. And of course, she's a nervous wreck about it all, as she would be. Sixth round. Macklin in the green trunks, of course, that you knew he'd wear with the big Irish connection, the Irish community right behind him on St. Patrick's Day and the big parade in New York. Is this the climactic end to that day?
I think Martinez has been told not to allow Macklin to come forward to claim the centre of the ring and push him back. That's what he's trying to do at the start of this round. Get him on the back foot. Macklin likes to come forward, likes to let the punches go, obviously can't do that on the back foot.
With a right hand there from Macklin, and his every punch is being cheered to the echo. Will that have some effect on the three American judges, you wonder?
Nice little feints there too from Macklin, thinking his way around here. Not all that accurate coming back from Martinez.
Not that accurate with the jab as well, and he hasn't really been able to thump in that left hand, which can be very, very hurtful. Not yet, anyway.
I think what Macklin's been doing now is just maybe four, five, six times in a round, have a big drive and let some big punches go, then get his breath back, then do it again. He's boxing at a nice pace. He's boxing so well, actually. Put a lot of thought into what he's doing. He's actually the one causing the problems at the moment.
Good stuff, this, from Macklin. There was a right hand there over the top from Martinez back. But he's setting problems here. And it's based really, I think, on a thorough preparation and a good game plan. Good, there it is, that body shot again. Whether he's getting enough of those body shots to take it out of Martinez, I don't know. There's a lovely countering right, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was a cute punch, but we've not seen an awful lot of it from Martinez as the left hand lead. Yeah, we are seeing some clever stuff from him, but who's doing most of the work?
Macklin, the former British and two-time European champion. He did win the Irish title as well amid all of that.
Now he's woke up a little bit in the last half minute of this round. I don't know if he's done enough to turn things around, but we've seen some quality work from Martinez in the last minute or so here.
Yeah, just got in the last shot at the end. He might have just nicked it there.
Don, thanks, mate. The meeting went great. I couldn't have done it without you.
That deal you gave me on kitting out the office, you really didn't have to do that.
Oh, no, that's the actual price.
And opening up early for me. I mean, that just went above and beyond.
Most of our stores are open 8 to late weekdays.
I owe you one.
Norton Internet Security Performance Pack. Your power against online threats. Now better than half price.
I love you, man.
Staples. That was easy.
Okay. He's trying to bait with the left hand. Stay low in the shot.
Well, there wasn't much to split him in that round. But I just thought that in the last minute or so, Martinez improved his work rate and maybe just nicked it. But Macklin really doing well, really well in this.
Round seven, green trunks, Matthew Macklin. The world middleweight number one, Sergio Martinez of Argentina, who was born when his countryman, the famous Carlos Monzon, was in the middle of his seven-year reign. Hard to score that last round. It was pretty close, I think.
Yeah, that was a close round, but I thought in the last minute or so, Martinez really produced some good work, just nicked this. I have him 2 points up at the moment, but so many of these rounds are so close. I love the left hand there. From Martinez, just a little reminder of what he's capable of.
Landed pretty flush, and Macklin just smiled back and shook his head. Might be one or two arguments about some of these rounds.
Macklin does so much better when he lets them flow. Doesn't worry about missing, good left hook from him. Doesn't worry about missing with the first couple, but has to put punches together. He won't tie this fella down, pin him down with single punches.
Trained to the minute, Macklin, for this, his biggest assignment. Plenty of respect between the two of them again. The finishing shot of the rally was from Macklin. Didn't quite land flush.
The heads came together there, a little touch of gloves. Really has been sporting.
No trace of animosity as well in the build-up. Both these two pretty classy guys. He's a man to be admired, really, out of the ring. Martinez, with his campaigns against school bullying and domestic violence against women.
Both hunting the body in this round. Macklin aiming punches. Good stuff from Macklin. Aiming punches to the chest as he threatened to do it. Good work again from him. Martinez claiming that was round the kidney region.
See, a lot of people thought though, that Macklin, oh, good, he's got him with the right hand there. Does he touch down with the glove? I think he did. They've got to score that or not. And Martinez is saying no. Wow. Officially, it has to go down as a knockdown. If it does, it goes 10-8 on the scorecard.
Yeah, that was a punch. It looked like a punch come push to me, but a punch definitely did land, and it's what the referee's interpretation counts. Well, big left hand from Martinez has spurred him on.
has woken him up. He's moved into another gear here. Landed quite a few at the end of the round, so how do you score that? Whoa! If that goes down 10-8, that might level things up a lot on the scorecards. It's big news from Macklin. Let's get a quick comment from Amir Khan. That was quite dramatic stuff.
That was a brilliant word by Macklin. I mean, Macklin now is getting his punches together. He's getting his back stronger, and that knockdown that he's got there, I think he's putting back up there now. I'll probably give it a draw now. Round about now, I'd give the fight a draw. But yeah, Macklin's doing everything perfectly. He's hitting him with some good, clean right hands and letting him walk onto some big shots.
See, what happened was, it wasn't going on the floor, but his hand touched down. You can see the legs tied up here, so often happens with a... I felt it was part of a punch and part of a push, but you can see he was tripped over.
Okay,
had justice on Martinez, and it was only his glove that touched, but if any part of the body touches the floor, it's a knockdown. But I think that was a bit of good fortune, good Irish luck for Matthew Macklin.
Yeah, I think you're right, a bit of luck of the Irish, but I think it was an authentic knockdown, because there was a punch. Just so happened that Martinez's legs were in the wrong place.
I wouldn't have gone over but for the punch alone. So I feel Martin was fortunate, but hopefully he can build on that. But Martinez has spurred him into action. He finished the round an angry man.
One thing's for certain, Macklin is making a serious argument out of this, but has he woken up the champ a bit with that? He looked a bit raw by all of that.
Good right hand from Macklin.
Again, the left hand. Listen to the Irish fans getting behind their man here. We're used to drama at Madison Square Garden. Remember the up-and-down thriller that was Nassim Hamid and Kevin Kelly? All the controversy about the Lennox Lewis draw with Evander Holyfield.
See, Macklin gets good length on his punches, a good long jab. Oh, but there's a lovely left hand again from Martinez. But with the right hand, he turns the shoulder right forward, so he's catching Martinez with some lovely right hand punches, but really he felt that one himself.
Yeah, just a single shot from Martinez. Trying to reach with his right lead. Finding it hard to land in combinations, both finding the other quite elusive, really. Nonetheless, an absorbing contest for the highest stakes imaginable in the classic middleweight division. Good right hands twice over, and then left to follow. He can sometimes just really put them together, Martinez. There's three again. This is maybe his best burst yet.
See, he seems able to step up a gear, which I'm not quite sure Matthew can do. That's the difference between the two of them. He just seems to have moved into a higher gear, produced, then get back onto safety first again. But that was some lovely work from him.
Good. Heads came close together. There was a right hand in there from Macklin as well.
Yeah, at the same time, a left uppercut from Martinez. So they're exchanging punches, and that's good news for Macklin.
I think what he's proving again tonight, as he did with Felix Sturm, is he is a world-class magician. Big left hand, Macklin, that one. That was landing flash, he's taken it. But he'll be glad to buy a few seconds. That landed and buzzed him up a bit, I think.
Well, Macklin is showing that he can box. Well, with the master boxer, he's not been outboxed, he's not been outthought. This is a terrific performance. I've got to see this round for Martinez. I think the knockdown has shaken him up a bit. It's certainly woken him up. Good round for Martinez.
Yeah, he moved to another level there, Martinez. Maybe ominously. Just let the brakes up a bit, it seemed, didn't it?
Is landing more cleanly with his shots.
Okay, let's go, man.
Knocked Macklin's head back several times in that round.
Keep the head moving and keep the right hand straight. Okay? Keep the right hand straight, baby. There you go.
You know, often we're seeing that, you know, bang, the punch landing, bang on and knocking the head back. Some big punches landed in that round.
Seconds out!
from Martinez.
There was no smile from Macklin that time, and a little shake of the head. That was flush. That was a big one, but he took it. He took it. Landed up on Paul Williams. Punch. A bit more concussive than that, and absolutely, well, it was good night Vienna, that.
Well, we know Macklin has a tremendous engine, and he hasn't boxed at a crazy pace here, so he still has plenty left for the last third of this fight. A couple of defeats, he's let himself down, running out of steam. No signs that he should run out of steam on this one. Paced it beautifully.
That was important as well, because he did fade a little bit late on against Felix Sturm. He certainly faded a lot against Jamie Moore, and probably learned the lesson not to use all the petrol in one go on that occasion. Here he looks to have, as you say, got it about right, doesn't he? We'll see what happens down the stretch in this fight now. He's still there to be won, I think.
Well, he's boxing every bit as good as Martinez is. We felt that the slick skills of Martinez would cause all the problems. That hasn't quite happened.
He's just got that edge in speed as well, hasn't he, Martinez? Here it is again. That punch you don't expect. He's so good at those.
It's that left hand lead, you just do not see it coming.
It's like a strike from a viper almost at times, the way he just finds the unexpected angles. Clever.
And I think he feels that's the punch now, because as he's used it again another couple of times here, just lead with that southpaw left hand.
Oh, it's another cracking left hand as well from Martinez, and then a countering right, his round so far here.
He's looking classy at the moment, Martinez. Matthews kind of trudging forward, but not really achieving too much.
Yeah, last 5 minutes or so, Jim, Martinez has shown why he is so highly regarded.
I thought as the pace slowed it would suit Macklin, but it's not quite the case. His own head is more stationary, and there's still a lot of spring in Martinez's legs. A lot of lovely punches landed by Martinez in this round.
A little left jab in there from Macklin, and it's not enough. The eye-catching work is now coming from the Argentine. This is just getting harder for Macklin in the last round or so here now.
See, there's that gear I was speaking of that he seems able to move into, whereas Macklin can't match it. Oh, he's digging the punches in now. This is a big round for Martinez at the important stage too.
After that 10-8 round, if it was a 10-8 round with the maybe unlucky knockdown or touchdown, Martinez has imposed himself. This is a darker time in the fight for Macklin. Let's hear what Buddy McGirt's saying for a minute.
Okay, when you start, hold your hands up, he starts running shots. You got to keep the head moving. Nice deep breath. Come on, man, you got to give me some more jabs, baby. Just standing there now, okay? And you're following him. Stop following him around the ring.
This is the big trial for Matthew, isn't it, at the moment?
Yeah, definitely. These are the championship rounds now, and this is when Macklin can't fall short, because he's falling short a little bit, and that's when Martinez is countering him back. Now he needs to step in with that double jab or double right hand and push him back now. I think he's giving too much respect to Martinez, and Martinez is coming back with some good shots. But, I mean, overall, it's been a brilliant fight. I mean, Macklin's putting a good performance on, and, I mean, a great chin. He's been caught with some big punches, but the way he's come back, I mean, I've never seen anyone take them big shots and come back like Macklin.
Round 10, 9 minutes to go. Macklin's really got to suck it up now. Can he come back, or has Martinez got this thing by the scruff of the neck now, Jim?
Who has the engine? That's the big question now. Martinez has always shown to have an excellent engine, because he doesn't waste punches, doesn't waste moves. But Macklin, his pace does perfectly, but this is where he has to really go for this. He has to win this round, has to turn fortunes back in his favour again.
Here it is again, the snake-like southpaw lead. HBO still have it level, our American colleagues. I must say, I've got it shading it to Martinez at this point, even with that 10-8 in favour of Macklin. in, what was it, the seventh. Got to pick it up again here, Macklin.
See Martinez claiming the centre of the ring, driving Macklin back, and if you drive Macklin onto the back foot, you take away a lot of his assets. That left hand lead. Macklin needs to tighten defences up and needs to block these punches if he's not able to slip them.
And just walked onto a couple. Macklin, has that just dented his confidence and level of belief? He's had to take some quite heavy ones in the last couple of rounds.
See the trouble, for the first time he's not matching what Martinez is doing. In the previous rounds he was taking good shots but landing his own. But we're not seeing the same quality coming back from him at the moment. Now two lovely punches again from Martinez.
Right hand as well. He is one classy operator, this guy. He may not be a Marvin Hagler of the middleweight division or even a Carlos Monzon, but he is extremely useful.
And he's flying at the moment too. I mean, you can see he's switched on. Exchanging punches there. But a bit of leeway, I think, to be made up by Macklin here. There's that southpaw jab. There's no answer to that.
It's all Martinez really at the moment. Doesn't look good for Macklin.
See, Macklin's having to force the work now and that just saps the energy. It's not flowing. His boxing was flowing well earlier, but not now. He's having to drive and force.
There's a little right hand there. His fans still trying to encourage him, but caught and disorientated for a moment there. Back towards the ropes, it was a Martinez round again. This is going away from Macklin.
You're holding your left hand in the back. Where's the mouthpiece? Water, please. You're landing the right hand, but where's the hook? Okay, you're getting one-dimensional. You can't be one-dimensional with this guy, okay? You gotta give me some more left hooks now. Round 11's coming up, baby. Yeah. Don't stand there and take these crazy shots.
The ocean must seem quite deep to him at the moment. Doesn't look like a 37-year-old, does he?
He doesn't perform like one, and he's moved into that higher gear, and he's stayed there.
Apparently he's made more money, Jim, from investments out of the ring than he's done from his ring career.
I'm so happy to hear that. Love to hear that kind of news.
And give us some advice later. Here's the 11th. Green trunks, remember, Macklin, who has to pick it up somehow now. Is it just running away from him, Jim?
It isn't my card, but it's time now just to go for broke. Just let the punches go. Forget about the clever boxing, the technical side. As you see, I have him 3 points. Okay, it could be a little bit tighter with some of the earlier rounds. You could dispute, but you can't dispute that in the later stages, Martinez has really shown his class.
This is where all the fitness and conditioning that Macklin has done will serve him well late in the fight. He's had to really suck it up for two or three rounds now, while Martinez has bossed the fight and given us an exhibition of his class. Can he turn it again in the last two rounds, Macklin, somehow?
See, I think Macklin's trying to counter at the moment. I don't understand that. He has to get his punches off first. He has to take the initiative. Easy sitting here, I realise that. But this guy is too quick and too slick to be countering at this stage of a tough fight.
Macklin so competitive for so long in this fight, but harder now. Damage to the face for Macklin.
See, Martinez was struggling to land cleanly in the earlier stages, but he's not struggling now. The left hand working a treat, good stuff there from Macklin. But this is so tough for him.
tries to step in. He's got to gamble a little bit. With that, though, comes danger of one of those quick left hands from Martinez. Macklin gets close and goes for it. It's kind of what he has to do, really. It's about as close as he's got for a while. Oh, good right hand from Macklin there.
There's some success, but not putting anything like a dent in Martinez.
It's been a great effort from Macklin now in this round.
Complaining about a low blow, that's the second time we've seen Martinez complain.
Let him go, maybe he deserves at least a share of this.
But he's just not landing cleanly with
left hand! Is that round again, the 11th, the one that Darren Barker was finished in, the other British challenger. Big shot. Up probably at about 5, mandatory 8 count. Is he going to be finished here? Martinez is after him. He wants the knock, and there's another one. Balco's in the middle of all of that. Bell can't save in any round. 8, so that's okay. He's on his feet. They're looking much the worse for wear now. And if there was any argument before, there's absolutely none now, not even on the cards. That's a 10-7 round for Martinez with 2 knockdowns. And poor Matthew Macklin. Can he go on? I don't think he can, you know. They're waving it off. Over after 11 rounds. Still the champion, Sergio Martinez. And it's heartbreak again for Matthew Macklin.
And everybody was pretty well aware who was winning the fight and which direction the fight was travelling. And I believe it was Buddy McGirt who pulled out Malinaji against Hatton all those years ago. So it was the right thing to do. Just Matthew had absolutely nothing left. He was being pinned by ferocious punches, solid punches, bang on the chin. The fight had completely gone away from him. Full credit to the effort he put up. But that is as good a showing as I've seen from Sergio Martinez for quite some time.
And it's a tribute to Macklin that he had to really produce all that dazzling stuff we saw from him in the last 3 or 4 rounds of that race. Sensational, really. No answer to it, was there?
I mean, I feel it was the bit of good luck that Macklin got that turned the whole thing on its head. The knockdown was probably wasn't a knockdown. Angered Martinez, and from that point on, to the class, and unfortunately the power came through. I mean, the punches are now landing cleanly and solidly, and Macklin no chance of keeping his feet there. He was caught with his feet a little bit square, so there was a slight chance that maybe it was exaggerated, the effect, but no. When Martinez moved in for the finish, you could see the punches were drilling all the way down to his boots. Tremendous performance from both men, but you have to hand it to the best middleweight in the world, because that's what we're looking at here. Just the resistance to the punch wasn't there anymore from Macklin. The heart, as you always expect, will always be there, but in such a tough, hard fight, the punch resistance just wasn't there any longer.
Now the Martinez fan club and family celebrate. He's some fighter, isn't he? Because he's a box of tricks, he's hard to work out, and he's got the power to go with it as well.
Ladies and gentlemen,
amazing speed.
Referee Eddie Cotton, after being advised by the challenger's corner he was unable to continue, calls a halt to the fight at the end of round 11. The winner by TKO victory, and still the universally recognized true middleweight champion of the world, Sergio Maravilla Martinez.
Maravilla means marvelous, and marvelous he was in the end. Amir Khan, your verdict, a brave effort for so long from Macklin, but in the end, class told, really, didn't it?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I mean, I have to say, you know, Macklin put on a great performance. I mean, he was catching Martinez some great shots, and we've never seen Martinez hurt before or put down before. And, you know, Macklin put, like I said, I mean, he threw some good shots in there. I think now we know why Martinez is the best fighter in the world. I mean, what class act he is. I mean, he put some great shots in there and he looked really good today.
He's certainly right up there, isn't he, with Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao on that evidence. It was a great effort, I thought, from Macklin against an outstanding champion. He's just come up short a couple of times. Now, he speaks halting English, Martinez. So that's it here. Matthew Macklin, his corner retire him at the end of the 11th round after a brave effort. It was close for quite a long time, but Martinez in the end, brilliant.
Congratulations. Absolutely, Ian. Thank you for that, Ian Dark and Jim Watt there and Amir Khan. And, you know, it seemed to wake the champion up in the 7th round when he touched down, and then he moved into a different class. He is the best in the world at the moment.
Yeah, he is, and I think it was a very good Martinez tonight. In terms of his movement was superb, and I don't think Matt could quite nail him and couldn't cope with the movement, Gary, at the end of the day. Very fast jab, hands very low, he entices you in, and then as you get into range, then his hand speed is very, very quick. I thought his speed, his power, but his movement was the key to his victory.
And because Macklin was now behind and knew he was, had to come forward, was that the key to why it was stopped, do you think, at the end?
Yeah. I mean, I think that was his undoing, really. I only had him a round or two down going into the 11th. And I think Matt knew he was trailing a little bit. He had to go for it. But he'd missed. He was trying to drop the left hand on him all the way through Martinez. And then when he had to go for it and left himself open for it, because he had to pressure him then. So that was his undoing. But what a great effort. He's doing himself proud.
Yes, and Martin, I mean, to start with, the first two rounds went to the champion, and then Macklin got back in the fight.
Yeah, he did. I give the first couple to Martinez, and yes. I thought it's going to be a bit of a walk in the park, this. And, you know, Macklin seemed to pick it up. And there was a couple of close rounds in between, but when, you know, there was that debatable knockdown, he did touch down, so it was a 10-8 round, but it was more his legs tangled, and that seemed to wake Martinez up, and, you know, he just took it to an all new level from there. I mean, Macklin, you know, it was a brave effort, but Martinez showed he was a class above tonight.
Let's have a look at round two then, because this is where we can pick up some action. Would you like to take us through this, Richie?
Yeah, I mean, it was a very fast start from the champion, Martinez. I think he must have looked at the Sturm fight. He knows he can't stand in front of his man. His movement was excellent. He just caught Matt there with a good left hand, well-timed shot, and he keeps his head to the right, so he's got good defence, head out the way, very accurate with that shot. This was early on in the fight. Hands very low look, extremely fast hand speed, just nips his head to the right there and throws that left hand. So his timing was excellent.
It was, and he was hitting Macklin with that same shot, you know, all fight early on, and just eventually, as the rounds went on, you know, they told, and it was that shot that
Macklin got back into it.
He was sort of riding the left hand, even though it was sort of catching him. Macklin was timing it pretty well, and he could see it coming as the fight went on. And as I said, in the last, you know, in the 11th round, when he had to put it, you know, more pressure on him.
But here, Macklin casting with a couple of good right hands, so he had some success in the middle of the fight, Macklin. But then Martinez then sort of upped his game a little bit, catches Macklin with a good shot there. And again, we know he's a great all-rounder, Gary, because he can fight on the back foot, Martinez. But also, if he wants to go on the front foot and actually force the fight to his opponent, he's brilliant at that as well because of his hand speed.
You wouldn't think he was 37, would you?
No.
I mean, his conditioning is on par with Manny Pacquiao, yeah. Floyd Mayweather sort of conditioning, where he does the 12th round like he does the first round.
He was dancing about then in that 11th round like it was the first round.
Did you think at this stage Matthew had a chance of winning this?
I did, but I think at this stage, in the middle of the fight, I think Martinez upped his game again. He upped the movement, and Matt seemed to slow down a little bit, whether those shots were getting to him. Because, Gary, when you take shots, the fellas will tell you, when you take big punches, it takes it out of you and you get a little bit more tired. And I think that's what happened. But Martinez seemed to go through the gears. He went to another gear.
Jim, understandably, was suggesting that Matthew should throw more shots at the time. And you guys were here watching it. But that's easier said than done against this fella.
He certainly is. And Macklin's tactics surprised me, but it was effective, you know, it was working. Even though it was slightly behind, all, you know, listen, don't forget, we're talking about the regarded by most people as the number three pound for pound fighter in the world. And Macklin's pushed in close there. You know, he's done a real good effort and he's done himself
proud.
His
main problem, though, Gary, was the distance. The gap between himself and Martinez, as the fight went on, the gap got bigger and bigger. And then he started to fall short with his attacks. So as he's attacking, double jab maybe, he falls short and then he walks on to counters. But he had some success. This is where he falls the knockdown. Yeah,
it was a
touchdown.
It was a knockdown.
Yeah. There's a shot coming up here. There it is there. And
it was fortunate, though.
It was
square on, but it was the angle that Macklin threw. The shot
I thought Martinez was looking where his leg was going to go for, to see if he was going to trip up and dropped his guard and he got caught. Right. But this seemed to wake him up. And, you know, as soon as he got this shot, you watch, he had a little trade and then from there,
he's got a balance.
What a great champion he is, because he just picked it up and it just went from there.
Yeah. He knew then he had to pick it up. He knew that was a 10-8 round. He then moved into another gear here. Lovely. He misses with the left hand there, but comes back with his right.
And what about the way the punches come in from nowhere? I mean, they're difficult to see.
Yeah. We spoke about during the fight, him letting the shots go from waist height, where they're off your line of vision, so you don't see them coming, so they're very hard to defend against.
And he's very clever, because he sets you up and you don't see him. He's setting you up 30 seconds before he's actually
and
through
it. And his speed was as good in the 10th round as it was in the first round. He seemed to be, he held that speed right the way through the fight, and that's why he's such a good champion.
And Buddy McGirt, who's been world champion twice, he knows all about it. Great decision to pull Matthew out.
Right decision, wouldn't it?
I mean, at the end of the day, we've spoke about before, the referees should have stopped that fight earlier on. Definitely, Buddy McGirt made the right decision, because we were saying we don't want him to get knocked out. You know, he's given a great effort. He's given all he can. He's, you know, he's very brave, but Buddy McGirt, right decision.
But he was dishing out some stick, and this is the champion, and here we come into the 11th.
Yeah. Great shot. Left hand. Yeah.
See, this is what I say, he was looking great for that shot all night, and because Matthew had to go for it, he left himself open for it, but, I mean,
the timing
was beautiful.
But there, again, see, Matt's actually thrown a left hook, but he's been beaten to the shot, straight shot, and he was beaten all night, wasn't he?
His timing was good at all night. His range was fantastic as well. You know, Macklin was falling short with a lot of shots, and he was great at just hitting him just with his jab.
Yeah. He knows how to finish a fighter off, certainly.
Yeah, as soon as he's got you, he's on you, then he pounces all over you.
See, and one of Matthew's biggest assets is he never knows when he's beat. You know, there's no quitting him.
Oh, he's game.
And that's why the corner had to save him, because he would have never quit.
It was a good decision.
Never quite sure how all the judges never get together. Two judges had him leading Martinez by 4 points, the other judge had it level.
What, really? before it was stopped?
That's a bit surprising. I didn't have it like that.
I had him, Martinez, 6 points in front with a 10-7 in that 11th round.
I'll tell you what, we can go back to Madison Square Garden now, because the HBO interviewer, Larry Merchant, well-known veteran and been around for years, good interviewer, he's now with Matthew Macklin.
Matthew, thank you for an excellent fight. It seemed that you had a really good game plan you were executing in the first 7-8 rounds. What was it?
Well, you know, I talked about going to war all week and the whole build-up to the fight. In the Felix Stone fight, that's what it did, pretty much. Took it straight to him from the first foul. But I figured that you couldn't really do that with a guy like Sergio. He just, you know, by the time you wanted it to get hard, or you wanted to be coming on strong, you'd be busted off and there'd be too much taken out of you. So, you know, putting reckless pressure on would have been detrimental. So I tried to feint, move my head, box, take him out of his rhythm, you know, offset him a little bit, and ease my way into the fight, and then start putting the pressure on.
Did you think you were winning the fight as it went along?
Yeah, I thought that I had the most momentum. I thought I was in the driver's seat. Some of the rounds were close, but I felt that I was dictating things in there. I was the one who was boxing to the game plan, and I was taking him out of his.
What did he do that suddenly changed everything in the 9th round?
Well, I think maybe it was the round when I switched off a little bit upstairs and stopped moving my head a little bit. He caught me, I think certainly for the first knockdown, it was more of a balanced shot. It caught me square.
Is that fatiguing you? Because it was getting to be a more intense fight. He was coming at you.
Yeah, it wasn't like, you know, extreme fatigue, because it wasn't that type of a fight. But I think I certainly maybe slowed a little bit. Like I said, stopped maybe moving my head, got a little bit heavy on my feet, you know, and with that, he's a sharp counterpuncher. He caught me square a few times, and that allowed him to get his confidence up and get into his rhythm.
How do you think your countrymen internationally will accept your effort tonight? Do you think you gave them everything they could have hoped for in a challenge to the middleweight champion?
Well, you know, there's one thing I can put my hand on my heart and say throughout my life. I've never, ever quit. I wanted to continue. William McGurk, my trainer, you know, he called it, and I'd never object with him. He's a good, he's a great trainer. He knows what he's looking at. But, you know, I'm never going to quit. And I think I gave it 100%. I think everyone that watched would agree. And hopefully I didn't, you know, didn't let anyone down. And
thank you.
I didn't let myself down.
Thank you very much, Matthew.
Thank you.
Jim?
And there goes the best middleweight on the planet, Sergio Martinez. What a performance that was. And, you know, the fight looked really interesting after the knockdown or the touchdown, the seventh. But from then on, we knew exactly what was going to happen, I think.
Yeah, I think so. After that knockdown,
it'll be an awful lot of fun.